रोशनी धर, वेलकम टू मेडिकल डायलॉग्स, डेली डोज ऑफ हेल्थ एंड मेडिकल न्यूज। लेट्स लुक एट टुडेस टॉप हेल्थ न्यूज। WHO अप्रूव्स द फर्स्ट मलेरिया वैक्सीन इन मेजर ब्रेक थ्रू। आयुष मिनिस्ट्री सेड गिलोय इज सेफ फॉर यूज। ICMR लॉन्चेस मुद्रा टूल बॉक्स फॉर डिमेंशिया पेशेंट्स इन 5 इंडियन लैंग्वेजेस। NMC grants provisional recognition to PG medical qualifications for 1 year. The WHO on Wednesday endorsed the first ever vaccine to prevent malaria called Mosquirix. The new vaccine is given in 3 doses between ages 5 and 17 months and a 4th dose roughly 18 months later. Malaria is among the oldest known and the deadliest of infectious diseases. It kills about 500,000 people each year. The new vaccine made by GlaxoSmithKline raises a child's immune system to thwart Plasmodium falciparum, the deadliest of 5 malaria pathogens and the most prevalent in Africa. The vaccine is not just the first for malaria, it is the first for any parasitic disease. In clinical trials, the vaccine had an efficiency of about 50% against severe malaria in the first year, but dropped close to zero by the 4th year. And the trials did not measure the vaccine's impact on preventing deaths, which has led some experts to question whether it is a worthwhile investment in countries with countless other intractable problems. But severe malaria counts for up to 50% of malaria deaths and is considered a reliable proximal indicator of mortality, said Dr. Mary Hamill, who leads WHO's malaria vaccine implementation program. Giloy or Guduchi, which is an Ayurvedic medicine used to treat a wide range of issues including fever, infections, diarrhea and diabetes, also known as Tenspora cordifella, and is safe to use, but similar looking plants like Tenspora crispa may be harmful. The Ministry of Ayush said on Tuesday after concerns were raised over its safety in some scientific journals and social media posts. In an advisory, the ministry said, "It is reiterated that Giloy is a safe and effective Ayurveda medicine. However, it is advisable to use it in consultation with a qualified registered Ayush physician." The Ministry of Ayush notice notifies safety concerns on the use of Giloy that were published in social media and in some scientific journals. The ministry in the statement said, "This advisory is being issued to confirm that Giloy is safe to use, but some similar looking plants like Tenspora crispa may be harmful. Giloy is a popularly known herb and is being used in therapeutics since long in Ayush systems." ICMR on 6 October released a multilingual dementia research and assessment toolbox in 5 Indian languages. Dementia refers to a neurological disorder that causes a decline in a person's cognition and affects their ability to carry on with day-to-day activities. Despite the high number of people with dementia in the country, only 1 in 10 people with dementia are diagnosed in India due to low awareness. Dr. Balram Bhargava, Director General of ICMR, said, "This was one of the crucial needs for undertaking uniform, standardized dementia research in the country." He further informed that toolbox includes various cognitive tests to assess different domains of cognition such as attention and executive function, memory, language and visuopatial function. Professor Jayaraj D. Pandian, principal of Christian Medical College, Ludhiana, said, "The investigators had worked over the last 6 years to develop the tool in the Indian population." Keeping in the view of the COVID-19 pandemic and its impact on the medical academy and overall function of medical institutes across the country, the NMC has announced provisional recognition of 1 more year to PG medical qualifications for the 2020 academic session. The academic year consists of the broad and super specialities approved by the erstwhile Medical Council of India. As per Para 6.2 of the Postgraduate Medical Education Regulations 2000, the institutions shall apply for recognition of the postgraduate medical qualification to the central government through the affiliating university when the first admitted batch shall be due to appear for the examination to be conducted by the affiliating university. In the view of the COVID pandemic, some medical colleges were inspected physically, some by virtual mode, and the rest have submitted sworn affidavits. Therefore, the Apex Medical Regulator noted that the process of inspection and recognition of PG medical courses has not been uniform, and the recognition of new PG medical seats or those that have been increased has not been completed. In these circumstances, the NMC has now allowed provisional recognition of all PG medical courses for a period of more 1 year. That's all from the health world today. Thank you.
Never miss a medical update from Medical Dialogues. Like, subscribe, and press the bell icon.